Hello everybody, welcome back to the series on Indian Mathematics, Ganita Ratnakosha. In the last few videos, we've been looking at techniques of how to convert fractions into recurring decimals when the numerators were whole numbers. Now the same techniques will apply when the numerators are with decimals, for example. And these techniques are applicable only when the denominators are ending in 9876. So let's look at a few examples where the denominators are ending in numbers like 987 and the numerators are having decimals. So let's look at one example, 14.23/39. So the process is very similar to what we did earlier. So here we will divide by 3 + 1 = 4. So we'll go with that, with 4 being the divisor. Now I first resolve, divide the whole part of the numerator 14, and then go to the decimal part of it, right? So let's start. 0.14 I divide by 4, so I get 3 and 2. So 23. So instead of dividing 23, I now add 23 and the next decimal number, which is 25, and I divide this by 4. So 25 divided by 4 gives me 6 and 1 remainder. Now to this 16, I add the next decimal digit, which is 19, divided by 4 gives me 4 fours are 16 and 3 as the remainder. Now from here the process is similar to what we did earlier. Now 34 I divide by 4, that gives me 4 8 the 32, 2 as the remainder. 28 I divide by 4, I get 7, 0 as the remainder, and so on. So the process will continue. So this is 0.36487 and it will continue. Now I can stop the division depending on how many decimals I am looking for to calculate to up to. Yeah. So this potentially opens up the application of this kind of method to resolve a lot of divisions easily. Let's look at one more example. So let's say we were doing 25.87 divided by 68. Okay. Here I'll divide with 6 + 1 = 7, and the quotient number I adjust, multiply by 2 each time. Should not fall because it is 8. So let's start dividing. 25 by 6, start with 25 divided by 6, I get 6 4s are 24 and 1 is the remainder. So 1 is the remainder, then 2 times 4, this is 18. Now to 18 I have to add 1 8, so that gives me 26. Now 26 I divide by 7. 26 over 7 gives me 7, 3s are 21, 5 is the remainder, 2 into 3, that is 56, plus 7, that is 63. Now 63 I divide by 7, that gives me 9. Now 9 and 0 is the remainder, 0 and 9 2s are 18, so 18 divided by 7, next. So 7 2s are 14, 4 is the remainder, and so on, and the process will continue. So 4 is the remainder and then I can continue. So this is 0.4392 and it will continue. So this is how I can divide 25.87 by 68. Let's look at one more example. It can also apply for larger denominators like 498, 599, etc. So 46.32 divided by 498. Now here I will operate in two digits after resolving the whole part of the numerator. So 46 I divide with 4 + 1 = 5. 4 + 1 = 5, so I will divide with 5. So 46 over 5 is 9 times. Now I have to write each as a two digit number, so I write 09 because I am dealing with 498. and the remainder is 1. So 1 is the remainder, 2 into 09, that gives me 118. And to 118 I have to add 32, because even in the decimals I will add in pairs each time. So this gives me 150. 150 over 5 is 30, and 0 is the remainder. 2 into 30, that is 60. There is nothing else to add. Now 60 over 5 gives me 12, and so on, it will continue. So the answer is 0.093012, and so on and so forth. So this is how we can now extend the process we have used for denominators ending in 9876 with whole numerators to calculating divisions where the numerator is not a whole number but has decimals in it. I have given some problems to try in the notes. Please do try them out, and you will also find the solutions on the website. Please do have a look at them. For any clarifications or suggestions, please do write to me. Thank you.